Oh boy, oh joy, it's Akoi. Hello again there, friends and fans. Raptor here, and welcome to the preview update for Grounded. This game is amazing, and the update for it is coming soon called the Water Update that is going to bring Akoi and many other things to the game, and we've got a lot to show you. So if you haven't yet subscribed, make sure you do, and make sure you smash that like button in order to see more and turn on that notification bell. This footage here, provided by my good friend Sir Simalot. You can check out his channel down below in the description. Make sure to support him because me and him will be bringing a lot of footage for this game on all the secrets and upcoming stuff as soon as we find it. I've been busy doing other things, so make sure you subscribe to him. We found all the secrets in this game. We know all the things that are coming soon. So again, if you want to see it, make sure you do turn on that notification bell so you don't miss out. Also, we're wearing some special armor here, which allows you to become a better swimmer and better diver. So this koi armor, which you can see there, a little like the flippers on your feet, will allow you to swim faster. And the helmet made of the koi will also allow you to swim deeper and basically have almost an unlimited lung capacity. Well, I shouldn't say unlimited, but it'll be a much higher increased lung capacity underwater. So that koi out in the pond will be available in the future update. Maybe there'll be more. Again, we're kind of hacking deep into the files to see what might be coming soon to the game. And that might be something that we'll see in the pond and maybe more of them in order to craft this armor. So you can see a few of the hidden things that'll be in the game later. We have lab chairs here, for example, that you stole the chair. And so you might be able to decorate your future bases with some of the lab chairs and take things from the labs and actually bring them back and possibly be able to craft them in the future, which would be interesting. There's also shiny ants that will be coming to the game in the future too. So we'll have to fight against ants that are the worker ants, the soldier ants, and also a new type of ant called the shiny ant. And there also would be an ant that might be able to spit acid. So you can see here, they're highlighting a lot of things. Bee fuzz, for example, and there's also wasps coming to the game. There's so much information on what's coming soon. We're also going to take a look at the mosquito here in a second or two as soon as we take a look at this other stuff. Water fleas, for example, coming to the game. We have diving bell spiders coming to the game as well. We can confirm that by looking at their parts here. For example, the water boatman fins, so that's something that you can craft, possibly out of the koi, since it'll make it a complete set. There's also leeches coming, and of course we've got ourselves granola bars, which we'll be able to find in the labs and store, ant acid, which will be used from some of those ants that will attack, possibly a ranged attack, so that'll be dangerous. Crickets too, confirmed. Look at all this stuff that we're finding in the game files, some of which are easily found in the creative, some that you have to unlock, so there's secret ways to do it. So again, don't forget to subscribe to Sir Simalot, a wonderful channel. The man's digging deep, doing a lot of work, and I'm glad that we're friends here. A debug sword? What is a debug? Well, it's just something for the developers possibly to test, but it could also be something that will be updated to possibly be a weapon in the future. But swords, instead of just knives so far, I don't think we have any of those. We also have clover gliders, so we'll be able to get some leaves from the clovers or whatnot in order to also glide. Perhaps they'll be different than the dandelions in terms of their reliability, and we'll take a look at some of that stuff a little bit later. So as you can see here, the armor set for the koi looks pretty cool. There's actually a koi head on the top there. It's actually blinking. I believe that was for light at nighttime. That's not koi, that's something else. But a part of the set, though, that you can change, and that looks pretty cool. Look at how amazing that looks. I love the armor in this game. It's all made differently, but its appearance looks different as well. So let's check out what's going down here under the water again. Where is that? What's that koi up to? Is he? Oh, there he is. Wow, look at that big boy. Man, is he swimming fast. That is really cool. Looks like he's actually taking a little bit of damage too. Maybe he fought some of the other koi as well. I'm not exactly sure. But definitely looks like he's going to be a fearsome beast. Now, when you swim next to the koi, for now, he's passive. He won't attack you. You can clip through him. He really doesn't exist in the game yet. So the properties for him to attack are not quite there. So possibly in the future, we might have to fight more than one of them at a time. And if wolf spiders are deadly now, imagine a gigantic koi coming out to attack you like that. That's going to be crazy. A lot of things coming. And let's fight a mosquito now. Here's a new weapon that we're using as well. Not entirely sure in the name of this one, but we'll take a look here soon. Mosquitoes are not currently in. There might be a quest that you've seen for mosquitoes to kill five of them or whatnot, but they're not currently in the game. But there you got a mosquito blood sack, and that is something that is collectible from finishing off one of those mosquitoes as well. So we'll have to see exactly what will come of killing mosquitoes, what parts you'll get, and exactly how they'll attack, and what attacks you'll need to block, and what the easiest way to fight them may be. Obviously, mosquitoes fly, so it's going to be a little more difficult to take them on versus, like, for example, an ant or even a wolf spider. So they might be more challenging or they could be easy. So we'll have to kind of see how everything goes. So you can see Sir Similar right now typing in different commands to the console to have the game spawn different items in. And so this is a way to take a good preview of it. Here's another mosquito now that's been spawned in. They really look beastly, just like a mosquito would in real life, too. If you've ever seen one up close, there's that giant blood sac, which is at the back of it. And they really look intimidating with those antennas. Looks like he's actually cleaning his antenna off a little bit there. And that spear looks good. I believe that might be... almost looks like a harpoon, but it is not the harpoon gun. Another confirmed weapon in. Again, we've got a list of every single item currently in the game. Things coming soon to the game. We know the names of other characters that aren't yet released, and there's a lot of quote-unquote spoilers here, but a lot of things to look forward to as well. Things that have already been hinted to, such as the mosquito. There it goes flying away now. Let's see if it'll actually attack. Looks like he goes way up high, and then... boy, this is going to make the backyard a lot more dangerous if you can be dive-bombed by a mosquito. Let's go up and take a look at him. Looks like he's just going to hang out up in the air. Possibly at nighttime, the mosquito might come down and attack you more. Maybe their behavior at nighttime will be different. Whoa, it looks like he just fell out of the sky. Did he die due to fall damage? I don't know. No, it looks like he's still perking. All right, let's hit him again and see what happens here. A couple more times, and it looks like he flies off. So this might be a good enemy to deal with via ranged weapons. So obviously, like the tier 2 bow to knock him out of the sky. Maybe you can hit him out of the sky, and then when he's down, finish him off with a spear or continue to hit him with a bow and arrow. Here's a wasp now. Oh, yeah, look at that. Boy, that is a big, beastly creature, isn't it? Oh, how scary he is. No, it's just a gnat, and they have a placeholder for the wasp over the gnat body. But the sounds are different of the wasp than it is of the gnat, so obviously they don't have the model yet in there, but it is confirmed that wasps will be here, possibly not in the next update, but certainly bees and wasps and leeches and more spiders, varieties, and different creatures are coming soon, and I really want the ability to tame them. Could you imagine the ability to ride a mosquito and fly around? There's that scene from Honey, I Shrunk the Kids where the kids actually grab onto a bee and fly around the backyard. It's one of the most impressive scenes of that game. And here's some bees now. Check it out. The bees' knees. Oh, they don't look too bad, actually. Honey bees versus wasps. So perhaps there's a chance that bees will be attacked by wasps, maybe, just like they are in real life. And a possibility to see where they make their nest. If it's anything like the ant hives, or the ant hills, rather, maybe the beehives will be something that you can go into in order to harvest honey or beeswax or honeycomb and come back later in order to continuously reharvesting those resources. Of course, if you attack a bee, let's see if you can actually damage him here. Wow, those are really tough to attack, too. Boy, imagine attacking that with a bow and arrow. Of course, just like the mosquito, the bees are not going to attack at the moment because they're attack patterns and their AI is not completed, so they're going to act a little derpy because the model is here and their flight plan is here, but really the brain of the bee is not yet programmed into the game. But it is cool to see what they look like, and they really look detailed. This game has some of the most impressive features I think I've ever seen in terms of details at such a small level, and I think that's why we keep all coming back to it and wanting to play it more. Unfortunately, we finished like the overall available story, and again, only 20% of this game is completed at the moment, so that means that there's going to be more and more story added, more and more enemies, and more locations to go to. And in fact, everything pretty much north of the pond, when you look at the map, is not complete. Everything what you're looking at right now on the other side of that wall is just grass. There's nothing there. And so even with the pond seems a little incomplete as well, because now that you can dive deep, there's probably going to be more added to the depths of the pond, and there'll be more creatures to fight when you're down there too. So that's yet another biome within the backyard. You've got like what seems to be the ocean. Like, this is a huge body of water for how small we are. More debug being brought up too to spawn more things and program more stuff. There's the koi again. And we'll swim around and kind of take a look at him. Very impressive to see the koi swimming around. I wonder if there's a way to actually make the koi swim in the backyard, like in on the land. That would be kind of funny to do. But boy, imagine you're going to have to get four or five friends to actually take on these koi. And it looks like Sir Simlot has spawned in another 3 or 4 of those. So the question is, how many koi are going to be in the backyard? And how is going to be the easy way to attack them? Is it going to be a ranged attack? Will you be able to fire arrows into the water? Or will it be the harpoon gun? Or can you throw your spear from the shore and possibly stun them and then come in and take them out? Are they like sharks, or are they going to be passive like ladybugs? I don't know. If I were a koi and saw something the size of a human, this basically looks like a snack. Little Max here seems like a snack, same like with Allie and Pete and anybody who is a character in the game is about the size of something that the koi would eat. Look at that. It's basically like a megalodon right now. And also, you can notice a little bit of a light. Sir Simlot has equipped a helmet that kind of has a lantern on it, so you won't have to craft torches anymore. It's actually kind of like a miner's helmet, and that'll be another good item. There's also a few items that you've probably seen before that'll allow you to carry a fungus in your hand, and it'll kind of act like it looks like a lantern, and it's fungus that has been put into a lantern that'll allow you to then carry that, and it lasts pretty much unlimited compared to a torch, which is a little bit more of a pain in the neck. So, all right, let's get out of the pond again and go back up to the workshop or the little workbench and look at some more stuff. So we've spawned in bees. We've seen that there are wasps, yet we don't see exactly what they look like yet. Some of the things in this game kind of look cute and cuddly. I'd say even the bees don't look that intimidating, but again, you're going to need to be able to take them down to equip what is the stinger spear. Well, that's what he's holding, and that, of course, is a bee stinger, so you'll need to take that down. Look at the diving mask, by the way, the huge amount of defense for that. But I would say that with the diving mask, it's probably incomplete. The diving mask, which he's equipped now with the little bubble on your head of air, that probably shouldn't provide that much of defense. Maybe it will. Maybe it will, but only that defense might be in the water. Maybe that's the way to take out the koi. Perhaps you can kill a diving spider in order to use that in order to get the koi armor, which then allows you to, hopefully in the future, will allow you to run across water. That's what he's attempting there with those, I forget exactly what these are called. But the little skis here are supposed to allow you to walk on water. These are probably made out of the spider there, the Strider skis. There's the koi scale chest plate. That's going to be a real good piece of armor. I would assume a koi scale, probably for as big as a koi is probably as good as almost as good as a ladybug armor set, although that's a little bit more to craft. But again, no item in this game is just one thing. You'll need to probably gather a woven fiber, possibly blueberry leather. And again, if you want to know the locations of a lot of these, if you have any questions, please do ask down below in the comments and load it up with questions. We will be making more videos based on your questions and your feedback, and there's not enough time in every video in order to cover all the upcoming features and the currently available features. There's the tactical harpoon gun, a gun that lights the way there. Looks like it basically is a bazooka. Look at all that cool stuff. I don't think it actually is functioning though. But again, another good item to have. Check out how cool Max looks holding that thing. Although the animation is not really complete. It kind of looks like a gas sack at the bottom with like a large tube. It's kind of hard to see. But the animation we're not supposed to have the item yet, so it's not there. All right, guys, make sure you click or tap that like button. Subscribe for more. We'll see you next time. Big thanks to Sir Simlot. We'll see you soon.